Hello friends, from today we are going to learn Java. The syllabus that I have chosen for this learning is ICSE class 9th. They have a book on Java. So ICSE has Java in their syllabus from class 9th till class 12th. So we have Java with BlueJ. For those of us who are learning programming for the first time, for them, BlueJ will be quite helpful. BlueJ is like the swimming pool of the Java programming. Instead of learning to swim in a river or in a pond, you prefer to learn in a swimming pool. So it's like a protected environment and it is easy to learn. So let us see how we can learn Java using BlueJ. You will have to install the BlueJ's software or the IDE on your computer. You will have to install the Java's JDK, the latest JDK. You can download it from Oracle's website and install it. And after installing the JDK, you can install the BlueJ software from BlueJ.org. After installing these two softwares, when you start the program, first click on Project and New Project and then give that project a name. Let us say Project 1. A new window will appear. On that window, you will have to create a new class. The class name will be the one which you give inside your program. Here in our first program, we are going to give the name Hello World. Once you create the class, it will create an icon in the project window. You will have to double click on that icon. The editor will open. There is already a default program, a sample program installed in there. You will have to delete it. Press Ctrl A on your keyboard and select all the text in there and then delete it. And after that, you can start writing your program. So this is our very simple program. I will explain it to you. We start our program with the double forward slashes. This means it is a comment. The text after this double forward slash will not be included in the execution of the program. It will be treated as comments. So if you want to write a single line comment, you can use these double forward slashes. At the beginning of each line, you can use these double forward slashes. In case you need to write a multiple line comment or a comment block, you can use this notation. You can start by forward slash star and then start your comments. If you go to the next line, start with a star and then type your comment. And when you want to end the comment, type a star and a forward slash. Begin with a forward slash star and end with a star forward slash. And in between, you will type one star at the beginning of the line. So this is how you can use a comment block. Now let us start the program. Public class Hello World. Defined a class here. Public is called access specifier. Class is our keyword and hello world is the user given name. You can decide what name you want to give to this class. We will create a opening brace and there will be a corresponding closing brace. This is the beginning of the class block and this is the end of the class block. From opening brace to the closing brace. If you look at a Java program, you usually will find indentation. After one line, you will find the next line is indented. The indented is done so that you can recognize these blocks easily. Inside a class block, there is a function block. Every Java program should have one main function. So this is the function block. We will declare the function here. Public static void main in bracket string args. There is a square bracket opening and closing bracket, a pair of brackets, string args, bracket close. Then there will be opening curly brace and a closing curly brace. we will write only one executable statement in this function block, system.out.print in bracket in double quotes hello BlueJ, bracket close and a semicolon. Now if you look at all these different keywords and other access specifier and other words, there are only two words that start with a capital. String starts with a capital, the S in the string and S in the system. Only these two things are in capital and all of them are, all of others are in small letters except the user given name. In user given name you can decide any number of capital or small words that you want. And then after an executable statement there is a semicolon. See, there is no semicolon here or here. It is only inside a function block and only for the executable statements there will be a semicolon. After the function is closed, for closing the function you will use a closing brace and then we will close the class from here. So this is a simple program. You can type this program inside the opened text editor of the BlueJ. If you want, I can paste a copy of this program in the comments box under this video. You can simply copy it from the comments box and paste it. After pasting this program, you need to first save it, and after saving the program, you need to compile it. There is a button called compile, press on it. After compilation is successful, you will see such message at the bottom of the screen. After the compilation is successful, you close the editor's window and then you will see the icon of the class Hello World. You will need to right click on that icon. You will see void main string args. You will see this function in the menu. You need to click on it. That will open another window. All that we need to do in the another dialog box is just press OK. And then there will be a small output window popped up, maybe at the left, top left corner of the screen. If it is minimized, you need to drag and bring it in the center and then enlarge it a little bit so that you can see the text inside it clearly. You will find our output Hello BlueJ or whatever you want to write in the output. So this is how we create a new project and then create a new class and then type your program inside that class. After that you save it and compile it and then you need to run the program. So this is how we learn programming in BlueJ. Now let us look at a little bit longer program in Java. So let us look at another Java program. To run this Java program, you need to create a new project inside the BlueJ's integrated development environment. First, create a new project in BlueJ. After creating a new project, create a new class in the project window. We'll give a particular name to this class. We have used a name called taste_fruits. T is capital, taste_fruits, that is the name of our class where the main function is located. And we have created three additional classes and we have created objects using these classes. So let us see how it is done. Java is called a object oriented program, isn't it? OOPS is object oriented programming structure. So let's see a little bit of the OOPS in action here. We'll create three simple classes: class mango, class apple and class grapes. These are the three names of classes. And each class we are creating a function called test. The name of the function is same in these three classes. Then how are we going to differentiate between one function from other? Because whenever we are calling a function, we need to specify the object of that particular class. So each class will have its own object and that object will call the function from that class only. So even if the names of these functions are same, they belong to different classes. Inside the test function, we are simply printing one line. There are actually longer lines. I will also paste a copy of this program in the comments box under this video. you can copy it and paste in the newly created class in BlueJ, and then save it, compile it and run it. So let us see how this program is done. After creating three classes, we are starting with our public class test fruits. The class begins from here. Public static void main string args. We are going to create an object of type mango. The first statement here is mango m. This is a variable declaration. If you have already learned any other programming language, then you must be familiar with the concept of a variable declaration. Suppose we want to use a integer to be stored inside a variable, then we need to create a variable of the type integer. If you need to store characters, then we need to create a variable of the type character. So we need to have a variable of that type of primitive data type. Each data type, the type of the variable has to be declared. But here it is a bit strange. We have declared a variable called mango. It means mango is a data type here. So in Java, we have a special data type. Mango is actually name of a class. Here you can see it is a class, but we are mentioning the class as a data type. It is a very special data type. It is called reference data type. It is called a reference data type. Mango M, the variable will be declared as a variable of the class mango. Then what we will do? We will store a new instance of this class, a reference of the new instance of this class inside this variable. So there is a keyword called new. When you write new mango and two brackets, it becomes a default constructor. Mango and two brackets, it will create a new instance of the class mango, and then the reference of this new class will be stored in the variable m. So that makes our m as a new object. For the sake of convenience, we call m as a object of the class mango. So there are two ways to create an object. You can use these two lines, or you can make it in a single line. Apple A is equal to new apple, grapes G is equal to new grapes. So that will make us three objects, M, A and G. These are three objects of these three classes. What does this object do? It can call the function mentioned inside that class. M can access the function inside the class mango. So if you write m.test, it will call the function test from the class mango. A.test, this will call the function test from the class apple. G.test, it will call the function test from the class grapes. And then whatever is the output of these two, three classes will be displayed in the output screen. So copy and paste this program and then compile it and run it. So for running the program, you need to right click on the icon of the class and then select void main string args, and in the new dialog box press OK. That will display the output window. So this is how we create classes and objects in Java. In the next video, we will learn about the tokens in Java.